गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर माधुरी चैटर्जी एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू विद कॉम्प्रिहेंशन. अर्लियर द टू कॉम्प्रिहेंशंस आई शेयर्ड विद यू वर नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द टेक्स्ट. इट वॉज समथिंग टू डू विद द पैंडमिक एंड द लॉकडाउन विच वी हैड बीन फेसिंग. एंड टुडे आई मूव टू अ चैप्टर विच इज़ देयर इन द टेक्स्ट इन एसेंशियल इंग्लिश स्किल्स. And I have divided into four parts so that it becomes easier for you to understand. It is about the birth of Khadi, and Mahatma Gandhi has been has taken this extract from his experiments with truth. So this is one a piece from experiments with truth, and it is called Birth of Khadi. I'll read it and then I'll start explaining. I do not remember to have seen handloom or a spinning wheel when in 1908 I described it in Hindu Swaraj as the panacea for all growing pauperism of India. Now he is saying, I is of course Mahatma Gandhi, and he is saying that he was the one who pioneered and brought the loom and the charkha and started the Swarajya movement. But he says that it was still 1908. He had not seen a hand loom or a spinning wheel. Spinning wheel is the charkha, which he describes in Hindu Swarajya as the panacea, as the, you know, as the medicine, as the as something which is which takes away all the problems. So it's a panacea for all growing pauperism of India. Now, what is pauperism? Pauperism is kind of, you know, you go pauper. That means you have lost all your wealth. It is even beyond poverty. Poverty is poor. Then pauper is something you have nothing. You know, you have lost everything. So the reason for pauperism, why India is so poor, the cause, the panacea, the medicine for all this, he believed was bringing in the spinning wheel or the charkha. In that book, I took it as understood that anything that he helped India to get rid of the grinding poverty of her masses would in the same process also establish Swaraj. He says that he believed, he understood when he toured the country, when he went from place to place after coming from South Africa, he went everywhere and he realized that to get rid of, to get away with, to get free from the grinding is something which is crushing, which completely you know, crushes you, crushes against, I hope you understand the meaning. Poverty is of course garibi and being poor. So the cause, the how to get rid of, how to get away from this complete crushing poverty of her masses, masses is the common man, would be in the same process. It also will establish Swarajya, and Swaraj and all these things go hand in hand. Even in 1915, when I returned to India from South Africa, he's saying, he returned in 1950, I had not actually seen a spinning wheel. Spinning wheel, as I am repeatedly saying, is a charkha. I had not seen a spinning wheel. But when the Satyagraha Ashram was founded at Sabarmati, now you might be getting a question like this, where is the Satyagraha Ashram or where is Sabarmati? I hope you know it is in Gujarat. We introduced a few hand looms here. So he brought in some looms, he brought in some hand looms, but no sooner had we all done this than we found ourselves up against a difficulty. He said that we had a problem, we brought some looms, but we started facing a problem. All of us belonged either to the liberal professions. Liberal means they were educated, there were some lawyers, there were teachers, there were professors, but nobody was competent enough to know how to start a charkha and what is required. So either people were from liberal professions or to business. So there were some rich industrialists and business class people, but not one of us was an artisan. Nobody was an artist who actually knew how to run the wheel, the things required for a wheel, how to make the thread, where to get, you know, how to put in the cotton and all these things. We needed a weaving expert. And this is where Gandhi realized that he needed a weaving expert to teach us to weave before we could work the looms, before we could start the looms, we could, you know, start the looms. Machines, it was necessary that we should be, educate ourselves about running, how to how to process the system. One was at last procured, and procured means he received it, he got it, he achieved it, and he was finally able to find someone from Palanpur, but he did not communicate to us the whole of his art. He found some persons, but the person was not able to completely explain how to do this job or to start the business. But Maganlal Gandhi was not to be easily baffled. By now, Maganlal Gandhi was another one of the disciples or something of Gandhi. He used to be around. He was not to be easily baffled. Baffled means not confused. He was possessed with a natural talent for mechanics. So he was, he had a mechanical temperament. He was able fully to master the art before long. So he was able to learn this art of weaving, and one after other, several new weavers were trained, were started getting training in the ashram of Sabarmati, and this is how the movement started. Okay, now this is one small paragraph I have taken, and I now want you to read the paragraph again and check the questions. I had explained the paragraph. The first question is, what did Gandhi consider a solution to India's poverty? What Gandhi thought would help the people of India to overcome poverty? That's the first question. Second question, why Gandhi thought Swaraj is important? Why he believed that Swaraj and the looms and the hand looms go hand in hand? Third, when did Gandhi return from South Africa? The year is given in the paragraph. Please check it out. Fourth, which ashram is there in Sabarmati? Now, just now I told you, read again. You'll find which ashram is there in Sabarmati. Fifth, what is meant by artisans and liberal professions? Now, who are the artists and who are the people belonging to the liberal profession? Where did they find the loom? Where did Gandhi actually find the loom? And who was the weaving expert? Did they find someone, and how did a person help them start the business in Sabarmati? Okay, these are the few questions, and then it will be followed by some meanings. Panika, as I said, is a cure, is the medicine cure for everything. Pauperism, as I say, you go completely bankrupt, is pauperism. Poverty, you understand, it's something being very poor, is garibi. Masses is, of course, the ordinary man. Baffled means confused. Weaver is, of course, the one who is weaving the cloth. So the person who is indulging in this job, and procure is to obtain. So I have already given you the meanings. Do the paragraph carefully. Read the paragraph carefully. And this is a 25 marks question which you will be getting on comprehension. Question of 25 marks, and this is the first question which you will be getting in the examination. So do practice, and I continue with the same chapter in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.